Assalamu alaikum. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. This is virtual class of Pakistan International School, Taif. I am Ms. Bushra Tanveer. This is Islamic Studies class for grade first year. This is our seventh video of this virtual class. In this video, we shall study chapter number 2 from Islamic Studies book. Dear students, after today's lesson, you will be able to understand the text given in chapter 2. You will be able to do the short question answer from chapter 2. Dear students, now we shall start our chapter 2, the Islamic Identity, book page 71, the second pillar of Islam, fasting. Fasting is another of the fundamental practices of Islam. The spiritual efficiency of the institution is universally accepted by all religions. The history of religions tells us that from the prehistoric times to the age of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, people have been practicing fast as a means of spiritual elevation. Dear students, as you know that fasting is also the one of the pillar of Islam, and it is the fourth pillar of Islam. Literally, the word Saum means imsak, which means to stop. In religious terms, it is the holding by the intention of worship from the food, drink, and the lawful relation between husband and his wife, and to hold from various breaking of fast from the rising of the dawn till sunset. The main objectives of fasting is to attain piety. Fasting month, for example, month was ordained on Monday during the month of Shaban, year 2 from the blessed migration. Dear students, fasting like prayer is also an act of worship. It is compulsory for all Muslims, both men and women. But children, pregnant women, the sick and the travelers are exempted from fasting. But the travelers have to observe fast after the end of their journey. Pregnant women after the delivery of their child, and the sick when they become well, and women during the period of special days need not fast but have to make up the lost days afterwards. People in distressed hardship or inconvenience are exempted from fasting but have to make up the lost fasting days afterwards. Dear students, now the importance of fast in the light of the Holy Quran. Allah says in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam कमा कुतिबा अल्लज़ीना मिन क़ब्लिकुम लअल्लकुम तत्तकून। और यू हू बिलीव फास्टिंग डेज आर इंजॉइंड अपॉन यू इवन एज दे वर इंजॉइंड अपॉन दोज बिफोर यू सो दैट यू मे बिकम पॉइस। दिस वर्स शोज दैट फर्स्ट थिंग दैट फास्टिंग इज ऑब्लिगेटरी, द सेकेंड वन फास्टिंग वॉज ऑब्लिगेटरी ऑन द पीपल ऑफ अदर रिलीजन्स ऑल्सो, एंड थर्ड वन द रियल पर्पज ऑफ फास्टिंग इज नॉट ओनली टू मेक मुस्लिम्स डिसिप्लिन्ड बट मॉरली एंड स्पिरिचुअली एलिवेटेड ऑल्सो। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ फास्टिंग इन द लाइट ऑफ द होली कुरान, द आया विच आई रेड नाउ, दिस आया इंडिकेट्स दैट रोज़ा इज कंपल्सरी एंड इट्स कंपल्शन इज टू अटेन प्योरिटी। फास्टिंग इज एन अदर इम्पॉर्टेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑफ इस्लाम, इट हैज़ ऑलवेज बीन एन ऑब्लिगेटरी ड्यूटी ऑन बिलीवर्स इवन बिफोर द एडवेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम। All the previous nations were commanded to observe fasting, and Allah said in the Quran, O you who believe, fasting is prescribed to you as it was prescribed to those before you. May learn self-restraint. Fasting has been universally organized by all faiths. It was practiced by people of all faiths in one form or another. It is practiced by Hindus and Jews. Prophet Musa and Isa practiced fasting and enjoined it on their followers. Hazrat Isa fasted, but this institution later lost its true significance. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was asked to re-establish this institution in its proper place and form. He was ordered to fast during the month of Ramadan. Dear students, now the importance of the fasting in the light of the hadith, saying of the Holy Prophet, a saying of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is that fasting is a shield for you as it saves you from sins in this world and would protect you from the hell in hereafter. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, has further said, when any one of you is fasting, he should neither use indecent language nor speak aloud. If someone kicks up a rose and abuses him, he should tell him that he is observing fasting. Dear students, and these two ahadiths in front of you, in these two ahadiths is given the importance of the fasting, that during fast we should avoid to use the bad language, speak aloud, and also we should avoid to use the abusive words. The next hadith are the tradition saying, a tradition says, every good act that a man does should receive from 10 to 700 times rewards, says Allah, but the fasting is an exception because it is for me alone and I will give its reward as much as I like. He who fasts abandons the lust and cravings of his appetite for my sake. स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस ट्रेडिशन इज ऑल्सो द सेइंग ऑफ द होली प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम इज ऑल्सो मेंशन द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द फास्ट एंड ऑल्सो द होली प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम सेड अ पर्सन डज नॉट शन लाइंग एंड मिसडीड्स ड्यूरिंग हिज फास्टिंग Allah has no concern with his doing away with eating and drinking. And also the reward for fasting, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam indicates the reward of fasting that just I have explained you in the hadith in front of your tutor screen. Allah rewards for the good deeds of a man tenfold to 700-fold, but reward for fasting is of a special nature. Allah says that keeping a fast is exclusively for him and he would himself decide its reward. As you know that Allah said in the Quran, As-sawmu li wa ana ajzi bihi means that the fast is exclusive for me and I will give the reward of this to the person. Dear students, now in the next subheading, we shall do the purpose of the fast. The first one, the purpose of fast is to create piety, taqwa and virtue in man. A poisonous in the touch stone of fasting. Number two, second purpose, a person keeping fast keeps himself away from all those things that displease Allah, such as drinking, merrymaking, lying, speaking ill of others as described in the Holy Quran. One who fasts thus earns very many moral and spiritual benefits. Dear students, the purpose of the fast, taqwa. Taqwa means piety. What is the purpose of fast? A Muslim does not eat, drink, during the month of fasting because of his faith and for his love and for fear of his punishment and also the person can get the piety from fasting taqwa it is a state of mind and heart which prevents a mind from evil deeds and persuades him to perform good action. And also, during the fast, the person have to self-control. The most important factor to motivate man to follow the path of goodness or to adopt the evil way is the selfish desire of man. If desires are subjected to commands of Allah, man's individual as well as collective welfare is promoted. Inhuman desires violate the will of Allah. A man is degraded to animal level. The real object of fasting is to make man wise by subjecting his desires to the dictate of Allah. A person who keeps fast for 1 month every year and completes an exercise to control his basic desires, he attains such a power of self-control which enables him to avert every persuasion of the devil or the shaitan. Students, now the next third purpose, fasting is a process of gaining Allah's favor With some discomfort only, the reward of undergoing this discipline is so regard that it stands the worshipper in the good stead during the difficult phases of life. Allah said in the Quran, Yuridullahu bikumul yusra, wala yuridu bikumul usra, walitukmilul iddata, walitukabbirullah, ala ma hadakum, wala allakum tashkurun. Allah desires for you is, and his desire not hardship for you, and he desires that you should complete the required number of fasting days, and that you should magnify Allah for having guided you, and that you may be thankful. So Allah said that this is means that the fasting is the not hardship for you, and he desires that you complete the required number of fasting days. As you know that there is a concession during that time, that if you are on the journey, if you are sick, and for the special days, and if the person are not be able to keep fast, then he can fulfill this requirement after the month of Ramadan. Dear students, now the next purpose, fasting cultivates taqwa or the piety in a person, since he abstains from ills and seek Allah's pleasure. Since a person who deserves fast keeps away from evils, he cultivates good habits and passes his time in virtuous deeds, he begins to hate sinful act, and he is able to control this even patience. As you know that we discussed the taqwa or the piety in the our previous point, and also the self-control, that how can the person control his self. When a man maintained a complete check over his desires for eating, drinking and sensual pleasures throughout the month of Ramadan, and avoid other moral evils, and spend most of his time in prayer and good deeds, he develop a taste for goodness. Roza is not only training for a man to control his desires, but is also an effective cure of his negative egoism. When a man finds himself incapable of eating and drinking despite extreme hunger and thirst, he becomes conscious of his helplessness before Allah. And when this feeling becomes permanent, it enables a man to avoid every action contrary to Sharia. The Holy Prophet ﷺ has declared that fasting with true faith and sense of accountability ensure remission of all previous sins of the believer. And also the Holy Prophet ﷺ said that there are many keepers of fast who get nothing out of their fasting except the pain of hunger and thirst. Now, dear students, the next subheading is collective benefits of fasting. Although fasting is an individual act of worship, it has several collective benefits also. A person who keeps fast knows fully well the pain of the hungry fellow being, and so has sympathy with him. Dear students, now I shall explain you the collective benefit of fasting. Fasting There are many benefit of fast. The first one which I explain you, social benefit. Hunger is in fact a great revealing experience. It shows man what it is like to be hungry. It helps them to feel and share other people's suffering in hunger and thirst. All Muslims, rich and poor, all over the world go through this experience of hunger and thirst. They all are brought closer to each other. And also, you know that in fact, it is a time of great festivities in the mosque, that during the month of Ramadan, the people gathered in the mosque at the time of iftar and also for the additional Taraweeh prayer. And this helps to strengthen the feeling and ties of Muslims, brotherhood among them. Students, now the second benefit, physical benefit. Fasting has also many great physical benefits for us. Abstention from food and drink for a full month of days does a lot of good to the physical health of the person. It gives the stomach a rest during the day when nothing is eaten or drink, and provides it with an opportunity to do an annual cleaning. During the year, many kinds of toxic matter and other unwanted chemicals are formed in the body, which, if left there, are likely to cause damage to the bodily system. So, fasting also helps to strengthen one's will and determination to face hardships of life. So, the next benefit, moral benefit. What are the moral benefits? Fasting teaches a man moral discipline through practical training during the month of Ramadan. It is through fasting that he suffers and undergoes trials of hunger and thirst. He goes through this hard discipline day in, day out for a full month. He abstains from eating food, drink, and from all other pleasures of life. And he does this willingly without any external pressure, merely in obedience to the command of Allah. Students, now the spiritual benefit of fasting. Fasting has immense spiritual value, for it is basically a spiritual exercise and discipline. It brings man closer to Allah and remove all barriers between him and his Lord. Allah said in the Quran, "O you who believe, fasting is prescribed to you so that you may fear Allah and gain your taqwa." So the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Abu Huraira reported, that the Messenger of Allah says, "All the deeds of Adam son are for them except fasting, which is for me, and I will give the reward for it." Dear students, there are a lot of explanations over there, but now we shall see the next explanation, economic benefit. Among other blessings, fasting brings enormous economic benefit for the Muslims community. During the month of Ramadan, the rich spend very generously on the poor to win the pleasure of Allah. And this generosity and charity enable the poor section of the community to receive sufficient fund during this month to meet their needs for at least a part of the year. Dear students, now we shall see the next subheading. द मंथ ऑफ रमज़ान एंड द रेवलेशन ऑफ द होली कुरान. अल्लाह सेड इन द कुरान शहर रमज़ान लज़ी उन्ज़िला फ़ीहिल कुरान हुदन लिन्नासी व बय्यिनातिम मिनल हुदा वल फुरक़ान फमन शहिदा मिनकुम मुश्शहरा फलयसुमहु. रमज़ान इज़ द मंथ इन विच वाज़ सेंट डाउन द कुरान एज अ गाइड टू मैनकाइंड एज क्लियर साइन फॉर गाइडेंस एंड जजमेंट बिटवीन राइट एंड रॉन्ग. सो एवरी वन ऑफ यू हु इज प्रेजेंट एट हिज होम ड्यूरिंग द मंथ शुड स्पेंड इट इन फास्टिंग. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द मेमोरियल टू द रेवलेशन ऑफ द होली कुरान. Fasting has been made compulsory during the month of Ramadan to make a man wise through fasting and enable him to derive true benefit from the Holy Quran. Dear students, now the relation between Ramadan and Pakistan. I shall explain you the topic. Ramazanul Mubarak is a month of blessing and forgiveness for Muslims throughout the world, but this month of significant for the Muslims of Pakistan that Allah blessed us with the gift of freedom during one blessed night of the month of Ramazan. The formation of Pakistan on the 27th night of the Ramadan guides us to the fact that a system of life based on the teaching of the Holy Quran should be enforced in this country. We had demanded Pakistan for the object of enforcing Islamic system of life in the country. Dear students, now we shall see the question answer from the chapter. What is the literal and conventional meaning of Saum? Literal, the word Saum means imsak, which means to stop. In religious terms, it is holding by the intention of the worship from the food, drink and the lawful relation between husband and his wife, and to hold from various breaking of the fast from the rising of the dawn till sunset. Dear students, the second part of the answer is in front of your computer screen. You can see the answer of the whole question from here. Now the next question number 2. Short question number 12. What is the reward for fasting? The following hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam indicate the reward of fasting kept with true faith. Allah rewards for the good deeds of a man 10-fold to 700-fold, but the reward for fasting is of special nature. Allah says that keeping a fast is exclusively for him and he would himself decide its reward. And the second hadith, the Holy Prophet ﷺ said, a person who arranges iftar of a keeper of fast will ensure forgiveness of his sins and safety from the fire of hell. He will get a reward equal to the reward of on reward. Students, now the question number 13. What are the social merits of fasting? Fasting habituates the nation and organizes the unity. It creates a sense of love for justice and equality and protects society from evil. Question number 14. What are the spiritual merits of fasting? The spiritual merits of fasting are written as under. First one, fasting habituates the patience and strengthens it. It teaches to adjust the soul. It finds in the soul the aptitude of piety and devotedness. Now the question number 15. What are the hygienic merits of fasting? The hygienic benefits of fasting are written as under. fast purify intestines, fast mend the stomach, clean, third one cleans the body. Question number 16, what is the relationship between Ramadan and Pakistan? The answer is, the month of Ramadan is significant for the Muslims of Pakistan. Allah Almighty bless us with the gift of freedom in this month. Pakistan came into being on the 27th night of Ramadan. This indicates that the system of this country should be based on the teaching of the Holy Quran and Sunnah of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Dear students, now the question number 17. What is the relationship between Ramadan and Quran? Allah Almighty revealed the Quran at once from Allah Al-Mahfuz to Baitul Izzat, which is also called Baitul Mamur, in the blessed night of Qadr. This was the first revelation of the Holy Quran. In the next stage, Allah the Exalted started the revelation of the Holy Quran in the month of Ramadan upon Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's why there is a special relation between Ramadan and Quran. So the month of Ramadan has a close relation with the Holy Quran, because both the revelation of the Quran to the first heaven and upon the heart of the Holy Prophet occurred in the sacred month of Ramadan. Dear students, now the question number 18. What is the reason of ineffective fasting? Now our days, our fasts are just a matter of routine, like our prayers. So how can these fasts produce the benefits? We do not observe the important conditions of fasting, as well as there is a lack of true faith and sense of responsibility. That's why our fasts are ineffective. Dear students, now the assignment for you. Prepare the MCQs from chapter 1, page 7 to 20. Homework. Learn and write short question answer which are done today. See you in the next video. Goodbye.